Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for giving me another day to live and waking up this morning. And thank you for all the blessings that you gave everybody in this room.
Thank you. expanding for our sponsor reading. Our sponsor reading is back here, hymn number 614. Number 614. Title, Father Instructions. Father Instructions. Hear ye, children, the instruction of a father, and attend to no understanding.
For I give you good doctrine, forsake ye not my law.
For I was my father's son, tender and only beloved in the sight of my mother.
He taught me also, and said unto me, Let thine heart retain my words, keep my commandments, and live.
Hear, O my son, and receive my saying, and the years of thy life shall be many.
I have taught thee in the way of wisdom. I have led thee in right paths.
When thou goest, thy step shall not be straightened, and when thou runnest, thou shalt not stumble.
Take fast hold of instruction. Let her not go. Keep her, for she is thy life.
Enter not into the paths of the wicked, and go not in the way of evil men.
Avoid it, pass not by it, turn from it, and pass away.
For thy sleep, for they sleep not, except they have done mischief, and their sleep is taken away unless they cause some to fall.
For they eat the bread of wickedness and drink the wine of violence.
But the path of the just is as the shining light that shines more and more until that perfect day.
The way of the wicked is as darkness. They know not of what they stumble.
My son, attend to my words, incline thy ear unto my saying.
Let them not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart.
For they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh.
Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life.
Put away from thee a forward mouth, and perverse lips put forward from thee.
Let thy eyes look right on, and let thine eyelids look straight before thee.
Ponder the path of thy feet, and let all thy way be established. All.
Turn not to the right hand, nor to the left. Remove thy foot from evil.
Amen. Amen. Our scripture reading comes this morning from the 34th division of Psalms. Amen. Psalms, the 34th division of Psalms, verses 1 through 8. The Lord have already blessed the readers and the hearers of His holy and righteous word. The 34th division of Psalms. Amen. We ask that you would please, ma'am, and please, sir, that you would stand in reference to the word of God.
Amen.
The 34th division of Psalms, verses 1 through 8. The Lord has already blessed the reading and the hearers of His holy, righteous, and divine word. The psalmist said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul will make it boast in the Lord. The humble will hear it and rejoice. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all of my fears. They looked unto him and were radiant, and their face will never be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamped around those who fear him and rescued them. 8 and 5 verse. Oh, taste and see. Let me say that again. Oh, taste and see.
Amen.
That the Lord is good. How blessed is the man who take refuge in him. I read to you the 34th division of Psalms. The Lord have already blessed the reading and hearing of the holy and righteous and divine word. At this time, it is time for our altar prayer. We need to continue to pray for Martha Davis.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We want to continue to pray that God will send down his Holy Spirit like he never done in this place. We want to continue to pray for our youth. We want to continue to pray for those that are in the hospital, those that are in the convalescent home, those who are sick at home, those who are behind prison walls, because we know that if we call on the name of Jesus, he is close enough to make everything all right.
Amen.
Amen. Like I said on last evening, amen. If I pronounce a name, if mispronounce a name, we ask that you would charge it to the mind and not charge it to the heart.
Amen.
I don't want you to go out here and say, did you hear Reverend Young how he pronounced those names? He said the wrong name, but I want you to know that we want to work it together. We want to be like on one accord, and we want to make the announcement. We want to make the name as plainly as we know how. And if I say a pronounced name, we ask that you will just say, Reverend, it pronounced like this. Amen?
Amen.
On our sick list, the special prayer request, we have Sister Christine Jennings, Sister Orme Parton, Deacon and Sister David Boyd, Sister Dorothy Brown, Brother Michael Brown, Sister Gladys Baker, Sister Renee Hauser, Sister Denise Humphrey, Sister Mary Elliott, Sister Arlene Pett, Sister Jean Ann Bates, Sister Sue Oyen, Brother Rodney Whitstone, Sister Virginia Doran, Brother Josh Jenkins, Brother John Williams, Brother Carl Hodge, Sister Joanne Simmons, Brother Darren Henry, Brother Carl Mills, Sister Nancy Wilson, Brother Joel Tan, Sister Fran O'Connor, Sister Diane Carr, Brother Mark Cox, the family of the late Sister Jenny Phipps, Brother Stephen Brown, Brother Curtis Lowe, Brother David Akers, Sister Geneva Cole, Sister Danielle White, the Bianca family, Sister Andrea Brown and family, Brother Finley Hickman, Sister Amelia Simmons, Sister Jessica Mills, Sister Sharon Bryant, Brother John Ridgway, Brother William Armstrong, Brother Carmel Smith, Brother Charles Kyle, Sister Jamie Burton, Brother D. Von Burton, Brother Andrew Smith, Brother Tim Sixth, Brother Tina Sixth, Brother Jake Sixth, all military personnel, all we are duly bound to pray for the leaders of our nation, and we want to continue to pray, amen, for Martha Davis.
Amen.
Amen. We want to pray that God would hold us so close together that one could not fall without the other. Amen. I used to hear the song that say, amen, Jesus would pick you up if he had to reach way down. And I'm a witness that Jesus will pick you up. But the Bible said that you got to have the faith by the size of the mustard seed. And if you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe it, you shall receive it. I'm standing on the promises of God. Well, is there any other prayer concerns that we needed that are not on our list? We ask that you would please, ma'am, and please, sir, Amen. State their names at this time.
Reverend Young, you and your family.
Bless you.
The Langston, Moore, Claiborne, Whitehead.
Bon Wilson.
Amen. I continue to pray for them. Any more requests?
Sister Kayla Jenkins.
Sister Kayla Jenkins, we'll be praying. Any more requests?
The Fulton family.
Fulton family, we'll be praying. Amen. We know that he is a healer. We know that he's a problem solver. We know that he's a mind regulator.
Amen.
We know that he's able to save us.
When
we call on his precious and holy name. Amen. At this time, we're going to voice our petition before an all-powerful and an all-hearing God. Let us pray. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you for your many blessings.
Thank
you, Lord.
We thank you for being God,
yes.
And beside thee, there is none other. Father, we come as humble as we know how.
Yes, Father.
Standing before your people.
Yes.
Father, we come, Master, realizing that we have tried all that we know how, and it seems like the more that we try to do it, the more that we try to figure it out, the worse that we get. But we come to you, Father, realizing that if we just call on your holy name, if we just learn how to make our requests made known unto you, if we learn how to come unto you, which are heavenly, you said, Master, that you are able to give us rest.
Yes.
But realize, Master, that you are a burden lifter. We realize that you are mind regulator.
Well.
We realize the fact, Master, that you are a hard fixer. Father, we pray, we come and we stand on the behalf of my brother and sister, not only our brother and sister, but we come as a whole, as Martha David's family.
Well.
We come, Master, asking you, Master, that, you would just rain down your fire upon this place like you've never done before.
Yes.
We pray, Master, that you would just allow Martha David to be that light that shined upon the hill that, people can see the good works and glorify you, Father, which is in heaven.
Well.
Father, if there's ever the time that we need you, now is the time.
Yes.
We come, not because we know that you got all power in your hand.
Yes.
Father, we pray, Father, if we walk, we start begging. We first of all want to say thank you.
Thank
for
you,
the clothes that you put on our back.
Yes.
Thank you. For the shoes that you put on our feet.
Yes.
Thank you. For the clothes that you put on our back.
Well,
thank you.
Thank you, Father.
For letting us rent our automobiles.
Yes.
To go from one place to one place to another. Father, we realize, Master, that you said in your word that whatever we ask in prayer, you said that we shall receive. We ask that you would just heal those that are on our presence.
Yes.
We ask that you would strengthen them.
Yes.
We ask that you would build them up. Where they have been torn down. Because, Father, we realize that you are a doctor that never lost a patient. Somebody here this morning, Father, a man that is going to court, we know that you are able to be a lawyer in a courtroom.
Yes.
Father, we pray, Father, that you would just look up on our station. We pray that you'll look up on the Facebook. We pray that you'll bless those who are watching by Facebook. We ask that you will heal and bless whatever they stand in need of. Father, we had 10,000 tongues. We couldn't thank you enough. But the one that we do have,
yes.
We can say thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Father, we pray, Father, that you would just look up on the request that have been acknowledged this morning. We know that you got it all under control. We know that you have never failed and you won't never fail.
Well.
But we believe and we trust you. We're standing on your word. We're standing on your promise because you said that all things are possible through you that believe. And Father, we believe it.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus that you have already heard our prayer. We believe it. And by the mighty name of Jesus that you have already sent your spirit in this place. Father, we just thank you.
Thank you, Father.
We love you.
Yes,
you do. Because you first loved us.
Yes.
I don't know what that needs may be. But I'm so glad that if you work it out for me, you're able to work it out for anybody else.
Yes, yes.
I'm so glad that if there's sickness, there's movement in their body, the pain, the wreck in their body, we know that you can heal because I know that I am a walking miracle.
Yes.
Because you heal me, I know you can heal anybody else.
Yes.
Whatever they stand in need of, I know that you're able to supply their every need. We praise your name right now. Because we know that when praise goes up, your blessings come on down. Thank you for the altar that around the altar this morning. Whatever they stand in need of, we ask that you grant it. Because it's all in your hands. You got it. And you've already worked it out. While we're trying to figure it out, I just want to say, Lord, I thank you that you worked it out. We love you. For in Jesus' name we do pray. Let every believer, let every child of God, let everyone that's in this house this morning say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's in your name.
Yes.
We do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, quiet.
Church. I'd like to say Happy Father's Day to all the fathers.
returned back. He's been a member, but maybe hasn't been here in a while. We do welcome you back. Thank you for worshiping with us today.
Amen.
We do have some announcements. In the bulletin, the search committee will meet Tuesday at 6 p.m. Also, the Youth Day will be observed next Sunday. Minister Kenny Madison will bring the Youth Day message. And Bible study is held each Tuesday at 2 p.m. via Zoom. The Zoom information is conference number 1312-626-6799, and the meeting ID is 836-76184-163. And the passcode is 603-827. The Zoom information is valid through August the 30th. And the casual dress Sundays will be observed during the month of June. Just another announcement. Bethel Missionary Baptist Church, they want to extend a personal invitation to all to attend the installation service for Reverend Jesse Jones on Sunday, July the 24th at 4 p.m. It will be held at Bethel Missionary Baptist Church. That's out of Morristown, 1800 Cherokee Drive. If you, your schedule permits, please join them for the special installation service. Do you have any other announcements or acknowledgments?
Just a couple of things. The meeting on this coming Tuesday will just be for the search committee members only, because there's an issue, a couple of issues that came up that we as a search committee need to talk about. And then I am grateful to announce that on the first and second Sunday of July, Reverend Young has agreed to continue to be our morning speaker. So our morning speaker for the first and second Sunday of July will be Reverend Clarence Young.
On behalf of the Sunday School, we wanted to say Happy Father's Day to all the men. And if you see me after service, we do have a little gift for you.
This is giving time. This is the time that we take to give what the Lord has given to us. We give back to Him. We are so appreciative that He has taken His time to continue to watch over us and to continue to bless us. And I like that change. Eternal Father, we come before the mighty throne of grace, as humble as we can and as humble as we know how, to say thank you, Father,
thank
for
you.
Keeping your hedge of protection around the Martha Davis Church family,
yes.
Those who are here, dear Heavenly Father. And dear Heavenly Father, as we give back to you that a portion of that gift that you have given to us, we are so grateful. And we ask you to bless our tithes and our offering. We ask that you bless those who have it to give, and even those who don't have it to give, Father, you know that they give of themselves, because
yes,
you are the creator. You are the one who made us, shaped us, molded us.
Yes.
And Lord, we are so grateful that you have opened up the windows of heaven, and that we can, that you send blessings down to us, as it was stated earlier, that we can give some of those blessings back to you.
Yes.
Now receive these tithes and these offers in the order that they're given, and we'll give you all the honor, all the glory, and Lord, we'll certainly give you all the praise in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
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 And the church said,
amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. worship Him.
Stand in references to God's holy righteous and divine word. Amen. Pray that when you find it, that the church say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I love it when the churches don't want to call, because when Jesus told his disciples, I want you to go over to the upper room and I want you to wait there until thou and thou with power. And the only reason and the only way that the power would have come down is because they was on one accord.
Amen. Yes.
Amen. Mark it 8. Amen. We want to be on one accord.
Yes, yes.
When it comes to the word of God. Amen?
Amen.
You find this word written. The Lord is good. You may be seated.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord
is good.
Is good. The reverence to Christ, who is the head of the church,
yes, he is.
Who is the author and finisher of our faith, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He is Alpha and Omega.
Yes, he is.
He is a problem solver. We give reverence to the Holy Spirit in his praise this morning. To the deacons, to Sister Young, to the mother of the church, to add to this great crown, the singing class of the Martha Davis Choir.
All right.
Hey, man, I'm telling you, man, if it was up to me, I'd be ready to go home. But I'm one of them scared ones, you know, I'm going to let God have his way, because, amen, the choir already preached to it this morning.
Right.
Amen. To the ushers who have been on their post this morning, we thank God for you as well. Man, like I said on last evening, I love to come to a church where people smile. And it scares me when I come to one that's frowning. I tell the wife, come on, bag up, let's go. Amen.
Amen.
We don't want to rub off on us. Huh?
All right.
But I'm glad that I come into the house of God and I see the warm smile. And then when I see the smile, it makes me, it's just like a contagious spirit. I want it.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We just give God the praise, because if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, Martha Davis, tell us where we'd be.
All right.
The Lord is good.
Yes, he is.
All the time.
The word of God for the children of God. Very briefly, if I could get a Baptist amen in a sanctified church hallelujah. I want to reason with you on a thought. The Lord is good.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I say,
the Lord is good.
The Lord is good.
Hallelujah.
That ought to make you want to run.
All right.
That ought to make you want to shout.
Yes, yes.
Amen. In spite of cancer, the Lord is good.
Yes, he is.
In spite of the storms in our lives, I stop by to tell you, Martha Davis, that the Lord is good.
Yes, he is.
Even if I don't wake up in the morning, the Lord is still good.
Yes.
If I lose everything I have, can I take my time on this morning?
Take your time.
If I lose everything, the Lord. been warned. And I cannot turn myself over. I stopped by to tell you this morning that the Lord is good.
All right.
I wish I had a witness here this morning who would help me testify that the Lord is good.
All right, all right.
Now my other ear has been deaf again. If I had somebody this morning that would help me testify that the Lord is good.
Yes, he is.
Have you got it yet?
Oh, yes.
Let me put it on repeat. I said, if I had somebody here this morning, amen, would help me testify and say that the Lord is good.
The Lord is good.
Like I'm going to talk to you this morning.
All right.
Like, I want you to help me testify and tell me that the Lord is good. Still in me. Y'all with me this morning?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Mic check. There is not a more beautiful verse in the Bible than the verse that is before us. But not only is it beautiful, but it is true just as well as beautiful. For those of us who live after Gethsemane, you know, I'm talking one that after the birth, resurrection of Jesus Christ, after the Gethsemane. That's who that, right?
Yes, yes.
Huh? Amen. Those that live after Calvary. Amen. And those who live to testify that there is an empty grave.
Yes.
Those of us who are familiar with the exceeding grace of God. Something about the twins. I love the twins. Mm-hmm. Amen. You're probably wondering, what are you talking about? Twins. Mm-hmm. All right. Grace and mercy.
Yes.
All right.
Those two walk hand in hand.
Yes.
You cannot have grace and not have mercy.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
But I thank God that the Lord is good.
Yes, he is.
We should have no doubt. Amen. That Lord, I'm about ready to close now, y'all. We should have no doubt that the Lord is good.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Have you ever done anything for you?
Yes, she has.
I'm going to say that again. Let's pretend like we in the stadium of UT.
Okay.
Huh? You know, every time UT make a touchdown, they're like, wow! They jump out! Now let me say it again. How many here know without a shadow of a doubt that the Lord is good?
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Israel or Judah.
Right.
In other words, it has no direct reference Because 200 years earlier, Jonah had been God's message of grace. Now is God's message of judgment to the same city of Nineveh. For the name Nineveh means consolation. It's a short form, amen, of the name of Nehemiah.
Well.
And don't you do remember, amen, that God sent Jonah to Nineveh to speak them about their corruption. But Jonah refused to, amen, to go because he knew that if he heard, if they heard the word of God, amen, they would repent. I'm glad, Martha David, that one day the preacher was preaching. I'm glad that I heard Jesus' voice.
Well.
When he said unto me, come unto me, all ye that are laboring and heavily, he said, I'm going to give you some rest.
Yes.
I was so burdened down. I cried myself, running to the altar, said, Lord, here I am. If you save me, I'll tell over. You see, Jonah, amen, he left and went to Joppa to catch a boat going to Tarshish.
Well.
And God sent a great storm to pull him over. Everybody been pulled over before? Oh, we got all perfect drivers in here. Oh, all of us. We've never been pulled over. You never got pulled over for a warning? Come on now. Is you with me, Mark, today?
Amen.
Huh? Did Mark's time pulling over someone will give you a warning? Because you did something, amen, they know that you. Amen. Well, give them, but he said, I'm going to give you a warning. And see, that's what it is with Jonah. Amen. God gave him a warning and allowed, amen, and pulled him over. Pulled him over. And not only did he pull him over, but Jonah has some charges, amen, that he got arrested.
All right.
He got arrested. And incarcerated him in the belly of a big fish.
All right.
You know the story. And God, and Jonah prayed. Amen, amen. How many here, even in the midst of the belly of the whale, how many of a big fish, how many here to pray? Your circumstance may be calling you, amen, in the belly of a big fish, but how many of you pray and call on the Lord and say, Lord, have mercy on me?
Yes.
See, Jonah prayed and God showed mercy. Did he have mercy on you?
Yes.
Aren't you glad?
Yes.
And by Jonah praying and God showed mercy on him, amen, by making the big fish vomit Jonah up. And Jonah made his journey one day. Amen. And then sometimes in our trouble, and sometimes our trial, amen, it may call us a hinder, but soon as, amen, our situation gets bummed up, amen, we know how to run and tell somebody what God has done for me.
Amen.
The record revealed that they repented and God saved the entire city. But their repentance was short-lived because the reason why, because if we are not long on God, we will be shortened on repentance.
Yes,
we will. Or every half a second, even though I might not know it, but I fall myself on my knees and Lord, forgive me for what I've done, forgive me for the thing I don't know what I've done. And I. Because I want to stay close, connect with God, and I want to continue to say, in spite of what my situation is, I still want to holler, Lord, you've been good to me.
Yeah.
Because if we long on God, we will be shortened. If we're not long on God, we will be shortened. But now there is unrighteousness has reached the nostrils of God. And he sent Nahum in judgment, just like he sent Jonah in mercy. Even though now mess the word of judgment and wrath. But I'm so glad that there was one bright spot. Because in the midst of anger and doom and calamity, verse 7 in the church stands out as a beacon of light, of hope on a dark, weary night. Have anybody ever had a dark, weary night?
Amen.
And you call on the name of Jesus, and did he come down and see about you? Yeah. You see, the thing about Jesus is that he's not going to tell nobody. Whatever you got a secret with God, you can tell him, because he ain't going to tell nobody else.
Right.
In spite of our dark, winter night, because no matter how dark or bad your situation may seem to you, just whisper in your prayer and say, Lord, you are so good to me.
Amen. Well, hallelujah.
No matter how broken, amen, your heart may be, even though your situation may look bad and your friends are few, but the Lord is
good.
And it seems like things are not going to turn around. Have you ever been in a situation that you tried all you know how and seem like it just ain't getting no better? Seem like every time that you try, the deeper you get. But I'm glad to let you know, even in the midst of your trying, you ought to tell God, say, Lord, I want you to know that you are so good to me.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Amen.
And I'm going to turn it over to your hand. I'm not going to worry about it because I know you have the whole world in the palm of your hand. I remember a song when I was caught up a little boy, he got the little bitty babies. Mm-hmm. Y'all remember that? He got the little bitty babies in his hand.
Yes, yes.
So if he got the little bitty babies in his hand, amen, just think about you and I, just think about the whole world, because everything belongs to God, and God is in control.
Yes, he is.
And she might. Things are not going to turn around. Because your enemy, we was in a Sunday school lesson this morning. Because your enemy seems to have the upper hand.
Alright.
Huh? And it may cause the child of God. Amen. The enemy sometimes, but don't you hear him, because God got something for you.
Alright.
God is able, amen, to make a way out of no way.
Oh yes.
You may think that you will never smile again. Mm-hmm. So your tears seem like they'll never stop flowing. But even in the midst of that, just holler and shout, Lord, you still good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cancer. High blood pressure. Sugar diabetes. Money is looking funny. Amen. I've had times in my life, brothers, that, amen, that my money got sharp. Didn't know which way my next thing was, but I just called on the name of the Lord. I said, Lord, in spite of what I'm going through, you are still good.
Yes. Yes.
You can't find shelter, amen, in the midst of your storms. Because every time you take 3 steps forward, you get knocked 6 steps back.
All right.
But in spite of that, I'm about ready to close now. In spite of all of that, the Lord is still good. No matter what time of day or night it is, the Lord is good. For this verse before us give us divine assurance. Because no matter what the devil throws at us, amen, had the devil throw the thing at you? Huh?
Yes.
But you know what? I've learned that when the devil made it for bad, God will use that situation and he'll turn it around because he is good. Whatever your problem is, turn it over to Jesus and have a little talk with him. And man, he'll promise you today that he'll make everything all right. No matter how bad they lied on you. Huh? Everybody lied on myself this morning, David.
All right.
There have been times in my life that I've been lied on. Huh? Ain't nothing about that, though. You tell this morning because by the time you get to your background, you're a whole different story.
Yeah.
But how the world is going to change it from that person until they got back around to me? They're going to change the mind of it. But no matter if whatever they lie on me, in spite of what they do, the Lord is still good.
Still good. Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Even though we had Trump in the service, you know him, don't you? Even though Donald Trump, amen, he was stealing from the poor and giving to the rich. And even though, in spite of that, God was still good.
Yes, yes, yes.
Because God, amen, controlled the Trump. Because God is controlling of the White House.
Yes, yes.
And nothing in the White House that God don't know about.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But whatever they're doing, amen, God is able to bring you through. He's able to take care of you in spite of what the White House says, in spite of the gas rising. God is still able to take care of us.
All right.
He's good. Because in mercy, he has recycled us. Can I borrow a skin a minute? Huh?
Go ahead. Go ahead.
And tell you what I'm talking about. Have you ever been to a recycling plant? If not, I'm going to tell you what they do. A recycling plant is where you bring things that are used and discarded. And they make it reusable. Mm-hmm. Amen. They recycle clothes, they recycle cans, and they recycle bottles and old stuff. Trash. Mm-hmm. Cardboard boxes. Plastic. Stuff that has been thrown away can be brought to the recycling plant.
Well.
And some use can still be gotten from them. Even though they were thrown away and discarded, Mark Davis, but the recycling plant has a way of taking what has been thrown out in a way and making it, amen, reusable again.
Well.
You see, Mark Davis, the church is a recycling center. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is.
I'm going to say that again.
Yes.
I said the church is a recycling center.
Well.
Huh? Because there are some folks in here this morning, you have been thrown out.
All right.
Amen. People have told you that you were never mild to anything.
All right.
People have, amen, given up on you. Some of us should have been dead and sleeping in a cold grave and should have been in jail for the rest of our lives. I ain't always been a preacher.
Alright.
I ain't always been a saint. I remember, Brother Dave, that things could have happened to me. I know that I could have been dead and buried, but God was still good. He allowed me another chance to make it to the recycling center. That I could come to those doors and say, Lord, here I am, save me.
Yeah. Alright now.
But we made our way to the recycling center. And God has taken what has broken in us and refurbished it and regenerated and remolded and restructed. And now God is reusing it for his glory.
All right.
Aren't you glad? Oh. Well, not only has God recycled us with his mercy, but because the Lord is good, he has also redeemed us with his grace.
Yes, he has.
And it's important to understand that in the word in the English language that there is a prefix re in front of it. Had to do with going back to the original stage except the word redeem. You see the word like rehab.
All right.
Refurbish.
All
right. Redo.
Yes.
All of them have to do with bringing something back to what it used to be.
All right, man.
Huh? But redeemed has nothing to do with bringing us to what we were. But redeemed is God's mercy, or redeemed is God making us, amen, better for the future.
Yeah.
I'm glad. Because, amen, the redeemed in grace.
Amen.
I'm glad, amen, that God has redeemed me. Amen, and getting me ready for the future.
All right.
That's why the songwriter took a pen and wrote the words, I've been redeemed.
Well, yeah. Well.
Bought.
With a price.
Or with the price.
All right.
Yes.
Yeah, if anybody ask me who I am, mark it is,
tell them. All right, man.
Go ahead.
Talk to
me. Amen.
All right.
Tell them that I've been redeemed.
All right.
Yeah. In other words, in that song, to tell them, amen, that we don't walk like we used to walk.
Yeah.
Yeah, we, oh Lord, don't talk the way we used to talk.
All right.
Yeah, we don't, mark the days, act like, amen, we used to act.
All right.
Why? Because we have been redeemed.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why we should thank the Lord for redemption. And it's all because that the Lord is good.
Yeah.
Yeah, he is good.
Yes, he is.
Amen. Because he loves us so much. Amen. That he didn't leave us like he found us.
All right.
Yeah. Aren't you glad?
Oh, yes.
Amen. When you're coming in contact with Jesus, yeah, you are a different person. Yeah, that's why we should testify and be able to say that the Lord is good.
All right.
Yeah, because if the Lord, amen, has been your doctor in a sick room, yeah, you are not, amen, to be ashamed to tell somebody that the Lord is good.
Yeah.
Yeah, if the Lord, amen, rocked you, amen, to sleep last night.
All right.
Yeah, and not only, oh Lord, did he rock you, but early this morning. Yeah, he woke us up this morning.
Yes.
Yeah, and not only, oh Lord, we was clothed in our right mind. Yeah, amen. Dry the tears from your eyes. Yeah, save my dying soul. Mark the days. I stopped by to tell you once again that the Lord is good. Do anybody know? Yeah. so glad that Jesus laid down his life for me. I'm so glad that he laid down his life for you. I want you to know in his day, he told him you can destroy this temple, but in 3 days, I'm gonna light it up. I want you to know that when he got there, they lifted him up. I heard Jesus say, if I be lifted up, I'm gonna draw all men unto me. Aren't you glad that Jesus draws you? I want you to know there was a conversation between two thieves. One of them said, if you be the Christ, why don't you save us and save yourself? But the other one knew that the Lord was good. He looked at Jesus, told Jesus, say, Lord, remember me in paradise. Jesus stopped down, looked at the man, told him, not tomorrow, not next week, not next month, not next year, but today, that's a deal with me, in paradise. He looked at his dad, told his dad, Eli Saka, which means, my God, why is thou forsaking me every now and then? In the burden get heavy when you're trying to take more than you can bear. Every now and then we find ourselves asking the Lord, Lord, why hast thou forsaken me? But I want you to know that Jesus never left you, because he said in his word that I'll never leave you nor forsake you. But I'm so glad he looked at his daddy, told his daddy, say, Daddy, into thy hands I commend my spirit. He died. You know he died. He died. They took him down. They buried him. They threw the new tomb. He stayed there on the Friday. He stayed there all the Saturday. He stayed there all the Saturday night. One Sunday morning.
Hallelujah.
He got up.
All right. Yes.
With all power.
All power.
In his hand.
Yes, he did.
Then I let us shout that even though he got up, the Lord is still good.
All right.
Have he done anything for you?
Yes, he has.
Have he provided for you?
Yes. Hallelujah.
Have he made your enemy leave you alone?
Oh, yes.
You ought to shout. Say that the Lord is good. Door of the church is open. Maybe someone here would like to come by letter or by Christian experience. While the blood is still running warm in your vein, Jesus said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man will come in and I'll sup with you, then you're with me. What a fellowship, what a joy divine. Lean on the everlasting Lord. He's close enough to make it all right. Don't put off for tomorrow, but what you can do today. Because tomorrow may be too late. Won't you come? Won't you come? Maybe someone here would like to come. Maybe someone here that has been trying to figure it out. The more that you try to figure it out, the worse you got. But I stopped by to let you know this morning, Dr. Davis, that whatever you're going through,
Lord,
Jesus.
God is good.
Yes, he is.
That man know. He is a provider. Whatever you need this moment, God got it. You just ask in him and trust and believe that he'll give it to you. Want to say happy Father's Day to all of the men. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I want to wish those that are watching by way of Facebook, by website, I want to wish all men a happy Father's Day.
Yes.
Enjoy the great food that we're about to eat. Amen. Amen. I just love you so much. We love your smile. We love your spirit. We thank God that he allowed us, amen, to come and to share with you a word from heaven. Next week, we got it at, there is a word.
There is a word.
From the Lord.
Yes.
He's waiting,
yes,
to give it to you. God bless you.
God bless you.
May ever, ever keep you. Be our prayer. At this time, I want my wife to stand up one more time. You might not know it. We missed the last time, but we want to let you know that you catch it this time.
Amen.
Amen. Stand up, Sister Young.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, I have to show this girl, though. And I told her I'm wearing my maroon today. They said, well, I'm wearing mine too. I said, I'm trying to be girl. I'm trying to dress like me. Amen.
Amen.
Trying to dress like me. I got my clothes. I love her to death.
Amen.
She keeps me straight.
Amen.
Huh?
Yes. All right.
But D?
Yes.
Sometimes you want to do things this way. Amen. But she said, look at me. She won't say that you look at me.
All right.
God bless you. God bless you. We love you. May we ever keep you. Be our prayers. Any announcements?
We have not have missed.
What
name?
Happy Juneteenth! Celebrate! Amen. Don't get right back to the Lord's Prayer this time next year, the Lord's Prayer. And if the creek don't rap,
yes,
I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. But next year, the Lord's Prayer, I got to get to know what places white men are in this big city. Amen. Men and wives will be a participant of y'all great things that heaven and marketing. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We want to be involved. We want to share with you. Wants to be there with you. Not only that, but when you cry, we want to cry with you.
Yeah.
When you laugh, we want to laugh with you.
All right.
Amen.
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 God bless you. Now may the blessed God and sweet communion of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Bless you by his forth now and forevermore. For in Jesus' name we do pray. Now we pray that when we leave this place, that you will be our pilot, not our co-pilot. Take us to our destination place, and when we get there, we find everything pleasing in your sight. Bless us this week, that we prepare ourselves to come back next week.
Yes.
We love you because you first loved us.
Yes.
For in Jesus' name we do pray. Let every child of God, let every believer say, amen.
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 Amen.